Welcome to Benning Extra. I'm your host, Nate Snook, and in this edition, we're going to be talking with Del McMullen from the Fort Benning Schools about all the exciting programs are offered here on Fort Benning. We'll also talk with Bob Chenoweth from Pinnacle, and he's going to talk about where your BAH goes. But joining me now is Major Clark from the Fort Benning Dental Clinic. Thanks for joining us here on Benning Extra.
Thank you, sir.
So February is National Children's Dental Health Month. Tell me a bit about what Fort Benning is doing to help educate the children on Fort Benning.
We have two main events here on Fort Benning. At Faith Middle School, we have residents in our Advanced Education General Dentistry program that will be teaching the kids about dentistry and preventive dentistry and also oral hygiene. They will be going into the science classes this month. And then also at the elementary schools, we have school children's screenings, which will be done by Mrs. Kathy Hatfield, who's been here for years, keeping good tabs on the kids and educating them in oral hygiene and prevention.
So I was under the impression that Fort Benning did not have any pediatric dentists, and they're only to serve the soldiers. So why are you here?
That's a good question. Fort Benning has a pediatric dentist assigned here to Love Dental Clinic because there's a one-year residency program for new dentists just coming on active duty. And during this year, they receive training and education in each one of the recognized dental specialties, pediatric dentistry being one of them. So I'm here to support the residents in their training program.
So you serve more as a mentor as opposed to seeing patients, so you have a limited amount of people that you'll see?
Yes, that's true. We are able to see a limited number of patients. Because it's a training program, then Congress authorizes us to see a limited number of patients in order to support the residency. And we're usually able to find those patients mainly from the school screenings that we do in February.
So let's talk a little bit about prevention. What can parents do to help prevent cavities forming in their children's mouths?
There are really three main components in a good caries prevention program. First of all would be to make sure that the child gets their teeth adequately brushed at least twice a day. First of all, to keep the plaque off the teeth, and then also just to apply the fluoride toothpaste on the teeth. And both of those things would help to prevent cavities. Secondly, it would be to make sure that the child is not getting not only too much sugar in their diet, but almost more importantly, having sugar too frequently in their diet. The third aspect would be, or component, would be to make sure that the child is being seen regularly by a dentist, every 6 months or a year, depending on their risk for getting cavities.
So you told me that the frequency of sweets is more important than the actual amount. You know, if Junior is nursing a bag of Skittles all day long throughout the day, it's more detrimental than eating like five Skittle bags at one time.
Yeah, that's true. Frequency is really the more important of the two issues. Every time we place sugar in our mouth, then the bacteria are activated. They break down the sugars, creates acid, and it causes, it demineralizes the teeth and causes decay. If you can keep those times during the day down to a minimum, then that means that the bacteria will be activated minimally, and you'll go for long periods of time where the bacteria aren't active.
If you can't brush between meals, whatnot, do you recommend chewing some type of gum? Is there any particular type of gum that's beneficial to dental health?
I would recommend that you choose a gum that has as one of the ingredients xylitol, which is a sweetener, and it has been found in chewing gum to help to prevent tooth decay.
So I've heard that cavities can be contagious. Is this something that's true in babies? Or
the bacteria that causes tooth decay is a form of strep, and so that bacteria can be transferred from one person to the next. In children, the bacteria is transferred usually almost exclusively by the primary caregiver. So in that way, it is somewhat contagious.
So I know all the kids like the different flavored toothpaste, you know, with the blue, you know, and the almost seemingly glow in the dark toothpaste. It's so bright colored. Is there a difference between that and regular toothpaste you'd get that you and I would use?
There's not a difference in the amount of fluoride between adult toothpaste and children's toothpaste here in the United States. The flavors and the colors, they really are just put there to be more appealing to the kids, more tolerable to the kids.
When children start losing their teeth and they start getting their adult teeth and they come in all kind of crazy and whatnot, when's a good year or age to start seeing an orthodontist?
The American Academy of Orthodontics recommends that all children are seen by the age of 7 for an orthodontic evaluation. Having said that, as one of the things that a dentist will do during the examination is kind of give the parent advice about, you know, their teeth and the occlusion throughout their, you know, during their exams, even as young as, you know, 1 and 2. But really, the age 7 is when we really like to try to catch those children that would especially benefit from growth modification in an effort to avoid surgery down the road.
7 years old doesn't necessarily mean braces at 7 years old. It's just kind of giving you a preview of what's to come or what you can expect.
Exactly.
Okay. So what we gather here in a nutshell is that in order to keep good dental hygiene, you really need to brush your teeth regularly and also see a dentist on a regular basis. What's the first age that someone should go to a dentist?
The age that we recommend children are seen by is 1 year old. Now, a lot of time by one, they don't have very many, children don't have very many teeth, but of a lot of it, reason is to talk about preventive caries prevention and oral hygiene with the parents.
Dr. Clark, thanks for coming on Bending Extra to talk about dental health and make sure you brush your teeth. That's basically the bottom line, right?
That's right.
Coming up next, we're going to find out who's Chinese and building Lego robots and walking across America. It's all going on in Fort Benning schools, and we'll have that when we come back.